What were you missing in this final game?
Well, you know, when you come to a game like this, you know that you're playing, a top team, and I think they play better than us tonight. So, especially in the little things, I think if we go through numbers or episodes, probably some rebounds, some easy shots that we missed, little things that at the end make the difference in games like this. But you're talking about Real Madrid. If Real Madrid wouldn't have had the injuries at the beginning of the season, they would have been rated as the best team throughout the season. So they had, a very, very similar path like we had last year, managing a lot of injuries, going through Panathinaikos in the playoffs and coming to Final Four in top shape after having they were very clever at managing all their problems and they are a very, very good team. You have to play a very, very good game to beat them, and Mr. Bogdanovic is standing right there, Udo was there. All I'm saying is we changed things, very important things for this team. So at the beginning of the season, nobody expected us to be in the championship game. So being in the championship game was exciting. Of course, losing it is not that exciting, but I think we just missed some little things to try to overcome a team like Madrid, and they deserve to win tonight. I mean, there is no doubt.
And even though you lost today, Fenerbahce had been in the last four Final Fours, three finals. So could we say that Fenerbahce is one of the most successful teams in Europe in recent years?
Well, Fenerbahce is definitely consistently on the top, thanks to our coaches' work and the players. We have been very successful, and that's where we want to be. So the goal stays the same. I said it many times. Being in the Final Four puts a stamp of excellence to your season, to any team season, not just Fenerbahce. So having put four consecutive stamps, it's a very significant step for the club and for basketball in Turkey. That's where a top team needs to be, consistently on the top, and that's where we're going to be fighting, understanding that there are 15 other teams that want to do the same thing. So I mean, it's not that every year you get there, but every year we want to try to get there and be here in Final Four.
And even though you lost today, Fenerbahce fans were still in the stands chanting for your team. So what would you like to say about
that? I think we have a very, very unique fan base, not just in terms of number, because we have millions of fans following the team, but also in how much they really make us feel their presence. I mean, what the yellow wave today, and watching them around in the arena was unbelievable. The way they follow the teams in any top events or even throughout the season, we find them we are so lucky that we never feel on the road wherever we play, and that's an amazing feeling for a team. And I don't think there are many clubs in Europe in basketball today that can count on a fan base like we have. So we can only say thank you, but that's one of the reasons why we want to be consistently on the top. We are proud of what we're doing, but we want them to be feeling proud as well. So it's a common goal.
And finally, you have the good chemistry as a team, good players, but how Fenerbahce will bounce back to the next year?
Well, every year is it's a new season. Every year you have to make some changes. Now we want to have a good Turkish League playoffs, and then we'll start going through the adjustment for the following season. But again, the goal remains the same. We want to be in the Final Four again.
Thank you so much.